Hi, I'm Joe Dalson, the author of WP to Twitter, and I just want to walk you through the process of setting up and configuring your first installation of WP to Twitter. Once you've installed WP to Twitter and it's active, you'll go to Settings, WP to Twitter, where you'll be able to configure the setup. It'll initially open directly to the setup page, and you'll have instructions on how to go about setting it up. We'll go through this entire process. First of all, you want to register an application. Twitter requires you to have an application in order to be able to post. The name of this application can be just about anything, but it can't include the word Twitter, and it needs to be unique. Your website is not a bad idea to use. The description is fairly optional. It won't be shown in almost any situation that your app is actually used, so it doesn't really matter. In the setup instructions, it'll tell you what URL you should use for your callback URL. Now, if you're developing this on a temporary website or on a staging site, this may not be the actual location you want to use. But for this purpose, we're going to assume that you're using this in a live situation. Having set that up, you're going to have to agree to the developer agreement from Twitter and then create your Twitter application. You've now got it set up. Now, by default, this is currently read and write. Yours may not be. So we need to start by going to the Permissions tab, and we'll verify that it says read and write. But if in your case it says read only, you'll want to make sure you change that. The instructions are detailed about what you need to have here, because this is a crucial part of being able to post information from your website into Twitter. Now we need to have keys and access tokens. So we're going to go back to the Keys and Access Tokens tab. By default, you don't have an access token, so you scroll down on the page to create that. You've now got all four of the crucial keys you need, and we'll copy them into our application. Most of them are very simple, and you can just cut and paste them as they are. The one exception is the access token itself, which, because of its hyphen, is sometimes a little harder to copy. So you want to make sure you've gotten the whole thing. Having copied all of this information over, you will connect to Twitter. If everything is successful, you'll automatically be shifted directly over to your basic settings page, where you configure whether you want only new posts to publish or also posts that are being edited, and you can look at which types of posts that you have installed you might want to be tweeting. You can also look at more advanced settings, and you can select a URL shortener. At this point, you have successfully associated your WordPress installation with your Twitter account.